So we're going to play the first hour of the game, and you can catch part two next week. So let's do part one right now. Let's have some fun. So we're going to start a new game. We'll leave it on normal. Put on a headset so I can hear this.
Look, my flies to cow pies crawling over every drop we ever used.
We didn't have a lot of time.
A lot of time? Wrong. We don't have a little time. Look, I don't mean to be Mr. Naysay, but you really think you got a chance in hell of getting to that thing before they find it?
I don't know. That won't stop her from trying.
Come on, Ghost. It's crazy.
Sparks, how long have you been operating on this ship?
3 years.
And you ought to know by now, when she makes up her mind, you have one choice. You go with her, or you get the hell out of her way.
Her ship, the Logos, being one of the smallest in the fleet, also, incidentally, the fastest.
We scouted the post office.
Is the drop still clean?
Niobe, this won't be easy.
Thaddeus was my friend. I knew him. He never used a drop before. He didn't trust him. Whatever's in that box cost Thaddeus his life and the lives of his crew. And I have a feeling if we don't get to it first, it's gonna cost us a whole lot more. So are you red or blue on this?
You know me, Niobe. It's not a choice. It's a way of life.
Because I know how valued my opinion is on this ship, I won't bother to tell you. But I think it's insane for you not to wait for a support team. And for the record, when I cart your bodies back to Zion, do you prefer cremation or the gardens?
Sparks, your faith in us remains a source of personal inspiration.
Well, I am what I am, and I do what I can.
Then can you shut up and hit the button?
Your wish, Captain. My captain is my keystroke colon double backslash execute command.
All right, so personal favorite for me was always playing as Niobe. That's better. So we will continue with that.
Why do you do that?
Do what?
Check your guns.
You never know.
It's a program. They get loaded every time the exact same way.
Hume teaches us that no matter how many times you drop a stone and it falls to the floor, you never know what'll happen the next time you drop it. It might fall to the floor, but then again it might float to the ceiling. Past experience can never prove the future.
So?
So you never know.
Here we go.
Also gonna give you some insight on how loading it actually looks.
The post office closes. There's a ton of heat in the area, but the package is still untouched. Box number is 731222.
Got it.
And hey, can you ask Ghost if he doesn't make it? Can I have his boots?
Okay. A 1967 Pontiac Firebird. And you get to drive it as you play the game.
Keep in touch.
Now, while the graphics are not perfect, let's remember this is a game from, like, 2005. Let me confirm that. 2003. That's even earlier than that. Loading. It's not something we really deal with nowadays, but here we are.
Thank you for visiting the post office. We are now closing. This office is open 7 a.m. to 5:30 p.m., Monday to Saturday. Please exit through the main doors in the central lobby.
Doink.
Starting trouble, huh?
Doink! Into the face. Now these guys will be very, very minimal in terms of skill required to take them down.
Sparks, the elevator shut down.
Yeah, I know. Okay, I've got a blueprint online. Now, it's too bad that elevator would have worked. Okay, hold on. I'm looking for another way.
I found a heavy mail elevator in the back corner of the main sorting area. It might still be operating.
Thanks.
Yeah, I think it's just easy to get behind this game because, I mean, they had, actually, for a movie game, super high production quality.
Could you please leave?
No, I don't think I will. Pretty solid roundhouse. Semi-destructible environments were nice too, so it kind of added to the fight itself. It had sensitivity controls, so like I could actually walk slowly, approach a fight. Yeah, it had licensed content, so that's the old Powerade symbol. It had some product placement, and...
What did you get?
We need help! Jesus, help!
Witnesses. Doink. Thank you. My favorite one is to do that kick and then run and do a flying kick at them. I wonder if these people were most wanted though. Like, I'm just running in and killing everybody. Random male guy. Meet foot. Get up. Oh, he got up. I also like this game because it's like the perfect mix of combat but also shooting and stuff. I thought it was really well done in that regard. I always preferred melee wherever I could. And giving the bullet time effects proper. I'm gonna see if I can turn off inverted, because that's gonna... I remember trying to snipe with inverted in one of the later missions and always having a hard time with it. Doesn't seem like you can. Thank you. nice. Pulling a gun on me. Oh yeah, that ridiculous corner turn. I don't need to curve bullets, I can curve people. Suck it, wanted. Hey, buddy. No, you don't need that anymore. From One Punch Man with the nut punch. Oh boy. This place is not so great when it's not on fire. Spoiler alert.
I think they're expecting you.
Cops are everywhere on that second floor. I'm calling your partner for backup.
spoiler alert, I don't need his help. I'm gonna kill them all. Would have been better if the loading was faster.
I thought security.
That's one way to collect weapons. So as you can see, the police are a significantly tougher character to fight. I mean, that's not saying much.
To breathe.
It's really toxic. You gotta stay up high, away from that stuff.
The cops are sealing the doors outside. Ghost is getting slowed down, so you're on your own for now.
Particularly annoying. Oops. Oh, I botched that. Ah! forgot about that when I was younger, when I first played the game. After I knew that would happen, I would actually always jump it. Are all done. This is where crap kind of gets a little bit sideways for these guys.
Sparks. Peel box locked up tight. I don't see any way.
Yeah, I noticed that.
And you didn't say anything.
There's a red conveyor that's above the main sorting area. It's down the hall to the left.
Okay.
Find a spot. Get on.
I don't know if anyone else is hearing that, but audio's a little messed up right now.
Just act invisible.
Seems like it's just a one-off. Okay, come on. That's better. Thank you. That window is still there, guys. One of the coolest parts about this is they made it in such close conjunction with the actual filmmakers. There he goes.
You've got the pack.
Easily one of my favorite parts, because they let you basically do their version of the fight from the end of the first one. Shot. Oh, that was good. That was funny. And this is basically where they try to burn the building down and try and get me out of it.
What the hell happened to you?
Ghost created a distraction for you.
A distraction?
Is there a part of the building he didn't set on fire?
That is just what I'm checking out.
The front entrance is a no-go. Have I got an exit?
Hold on, I'm looking at your options. Okay. You're not gonna like it.
Hit me.
Find the manager's office. It's near where you jumped out of the conveyor belt.
On the second floor?
That's the you're not gonna like it part. Just call me when you get there.
All right, here we go. Gun. I was happy to make that a fair fight. I forgot that they do that. I think, aside from Max Payne, like, because that would have the full 360 controls, I think that it plays very similar to that. I wouldn't necessarily put them on the same tier or anything like that, so don't get me wrong there. But I think that between the two of them, they are very similar in gameplay. And I'd have to say that this is, this was what really got me into the bullet time kind of deal. Okay, Jesus. Yeah. I'm dead. That sucked. Oh, that sucked. Yeah, we'll try again. Of course we'll try again. I used to know all the ins and outs of this part, but sometimes that's just... It gets a little harder to do, obviously, when you haven't played the game for like 10 plus years. Okay. Bitch. Oh, he was just, he's just not having any of my crap right there. He's like, I'm done with you. No. Look at this crazy, crazy chick flipping around and stuff. What is this? This is a gunfight. Why is she doing that? Now let's have a fair fight. Thanks for getting back up just so I could do that. Oh, right. This is endless. I forgot that this is endless. This will keep going. There is no, there's no finishing this fight. You just, yeah, you're, I forgot that there are some sections like this where enemies will just keep coming. And, there was a point where I would like just sit in here for like a half an hour, just killing everything over and over and over again. All right. Favorite sequences.
On the timing. You gotta put your back to the city map. It's across the room from the big window. Good. Hang on. I'll be with you in just a sec.
Typical operators always putting people on hold when they need it.
Now, when I say go, I want you to run to that big window in front of you and jump through it. Trust me, this is gonna be fine, I think.
Ready?
Go!
Post office. They're for someone else. I didn't do that. Yeah, I forgot in that sequence they'll just keep showing up. And so yeah, as a young teen with murderous intent, I would just run around and kill them all. Over and over and over again. I spent about like an hour in there. Just to see how long I could survive, and I was much better at, yeah.
Right behind you.
Sideways.
Okay.
No.
Surrender! I don't get it. I can't remember how this part goes. Right! I have to survive. Until all the green lights are lit, and then we're good. Get to the hard line. Ow. So I think I'm gonna have to ground you. You cannot ground me. I'm the governor of California. No.
Left in the next street.
All things considered, the driving mechanics are pretty solid.
They're right behind you.
Me being a bad driver, you know, notwithstanding. No respect. This is a classic car. This is a 67 Firebird. How dare you! I missed that flip the first time. Thank you. how sick of me it is right now. Alright, made it this time. Alright, so the last part of this stream will be the final sequence for this entrance and, you know, their time in the Matrix here. So,
fire escape on your left.
Hurry. There's a maintenance phone on the roof.
The phone is behind the roof access door.
Thanks, Sparks. I couldn't have been on the ground floor.
Oh.
Go. Find the door. I got your back.
As you know, if you are watching this and you're wondering, what's up with agents? You can't kill them, even in the game. So you don't try. When you see one, you run. So I always try to do this part as fast as I possibly can. You see the immediate references to the opening sequence of the first movie, too. Me realizing I can't go straight ahead. Yeah, the jacking out effect would definitely be something really hard to animate on this particular system. But yeah, that's the first two, three levels. I always kind of counted this part as like one whole sequence. So this is how I've always read this one. It's one whole sequence. So, you know, you get to the post office, you run through it, and then you drive, and then you escape. Like, that's one level to me. But this was, you know, this is my childhood game, and it looks like it has decided that it's going to freeze. So I'll play this part solo and get back up to at least this part being finished. And then we'll go from there, I guess. But that's Enter the Matrix. This is my favorite game, and this is what we'll be playing for Throwback Thursday until we've completed it on both sides. Not a very long game, about 8 hours per campaign, give or take. Plus the hacking, which gives you extra stuff, like you can earn a katana and character skins and stuff like that. So thank you for checking out this throwback stream. I guess this is more of a video, but thank you for checking out Throwback Thursday video. You can find me on Twitch for Pydera_74 or here on YouTube, Pydera_74. And thank you for checking out the stream space. Put your likes, follows, and subscribes in all the right places, and I will see you next time.